The verdict capped a prolonged political process, including an election campaign dominated by mudslinging and fake news, with many observers fearing that the dispute over the result would boil over into violence.
In this regard, this court has been greatly aided by the contributions also of the Amici Curie, and the court places a heavy premium on those briefs that were filed and those which were admitted. The final orders made by the courts. This is a unanimous decision of the court, and we make the following orders. One, the presidential election petition number E005 of 2022 as consolidated with the presidential election petition numbers E01, 2, 3, 4, 7, and 8 of 2022 are here.
But today, Ruto struck a conciliatory tone, saying his government would work to make Kenya a country for everyone.
This is a country, a democratic country, and you cannot force anybody to make political choices they don't want. Imagine even a law was passed that makes people prisoners of a certain coalition, that once you sign a piece of paper here, and they make sure you sign that piece of paper at night when the lights are switched off, and then you are told once you sign you cannot leave. You know, that is not a country that we all wanted to belong to.
As Deputy President, William Ruto was widely expected to succeed outgoing President Uhuru Kenyatta, but found himself exiled to the sidelines when his boss struck an alliance with former foe Raila Odinga, endorsing him for the top job.
The president asked me that he wanted a different team to assist him. He signed an executive order that changed the format of government. I no longer chaired the committees of cabinet. I no longer participated in making crucial decisions. So it's just as it is.
Kenya! Ruto!
A businessman with a rags to riches background and a shadowy reputation, Ruto had styled himself as a hustler in chief and champion of the downtrodden as Kenya grapples with an economic crisis. Both Ruto and Odinga had vowed to respect the court's ruling, with memories still raw of deadly violence that marred previous election disputes in East Africa's most vibrant democracy.